Now we are in the second class of controllers and compensator. In fact, second problem solving class of controllers and compensator. Here there is a common data question. The data is common for question number 5 and 6. The common data is the transfer function of a compensator is given by GCS equal to S plus A divided by S plus B. Now the fifth question is GCS is a lead compensator if there are 4 alternatives given, and this question has been asked in GATE 2012. So as I have already said in question number 4 of previous class, that for a compensator to be lag or lead, all the pole and zero must lie in the left half of his plane. So these two, this one, because here if A is negative and B is negative, then the poles and zeros both will lie in right half of his plane. So this will not qualify. So we have to check our options from A, B and D, which one is correct. So for a compensator to be a lead compensator, the zero should be nearer to origin than the pole. So if the zero is nearer, then A should be less than B. So in which case A is less than B? Here A equal to 1 and B equal to 2. So here A is less than B, here and here both A is greater than B. So option number A is the correct one. The phase of the above lead compensator is maximum height. There are 4 alternatives given at which, and this question has also been asked in GATE 2012. So what is the phase angle for this compensator, due to this compensator? So GCS is equal to S plus A divided by S plus B. If we replace S by J omega, so replacing S by J omega, we get GC J omega, this is equal to J omega plus A divided by J omega plus B. Now the angle due to this compensator GC J omega, this will be equal to tan inverse omega by A minus tan inverse omega by B. So if we write this in difference form, then it will be omega by A minus omega by B plus divided by 1 plus omega by A into omega by B. So it will be, if we take this will be tan inverse omega by A minus omega by B divided by 1 plus omega square by AB. So it will be omega will be common and 1 by A minus 1 by B here, and here 1 plus omega square by AB. It will be like this. So here it will be tan inverse. So it will be tan inverse. Okay. Now this will be maximum, this angle will be maximum if the term within the dotted line is maximum, because for maximum value of tan inverse the angle will be maximum. So we have to maximize this. So when this term will be maximum, we have to search when this term is maximum. For which value of omega this term is maximum. So now that our work is to maximize the term in dotted line for which omega. So now we have to maximize, let us write, now we have to maximize the term. Suppose we say this term as Z. The term Z equal to, say, Z equal to omega, or you can say 1 by A minus 1 by B, omega divided by 1 plus omega square A. Now, for maximizing, we have to differentiate this term. So, dz by d omega, if we make the differentiation, then it will be 1 plus omega square by AB whole square, and here the differentiation will be 2 omega AB, because the differentiation of omega square is 2 omega AB, and multiplied by 1 minus A, 1 minus B omega minus 1 minus A, 1 minus B omega into differentiation, minus, we have to write the differentiation of, we have made here the mistake. At first, we have to write 1 plus omega square by AB, and we have to make differentiation of this, and differentiation of the numerator will be 1 by A minus 1 by B. So, 1 by A minus 1 by B. Okay. Minus, here, again we have to write the numerator 1 by A minus 1 by B omega, and we have to make the differentiation of denominator, and that will be 2 omega by A. Okay. So, now what will be, if we take 1 by A into 1 by B in common, so 1 by A minus 1 by B, if we take this common, so how much it will come? 1 plus omega square AB. Okay. Minus here 2 omega square by AB. Okay, divided by 1 plus omega square by AB whole square. So, this will be 1 so this term will be equal to 1 by A minus 1 by B into 1 minus omega square by AB divided by 1 plus omega square by AB whole square. So for optimum value of omega, we have to make dz by d omega 0. So if we make dz by d omega equal to 0, for optimum value of z, dz by d omega should be equal to 0, and this will be 0 if 1 minus, this will be 0 means 1 by A minus 1 by B multiplied by 1 minus omega square by AB divided by 1 plus omega square by AB whole square. This is 0. This means, this only means that 1 minus omega square by AB, that must be 0. This means omega should be equal to under root AB, radian per second. Again we can check by double differentiating this, whether after double differentiating the terms. Babu, yahan dekho, dekho sir, bhai sir aaya thi hai, iska recording hoga, kar rahe ki udhar mat jao, udhar pahunch kaise gayi, खेलेंगे उधर, तो तुमको जगह है उधर आओ, सो Now we have to check whether this omega will give the value maximum or minimum value of the angle. So तुमने सुनेगी तो ले जाओ चप्पल. Now we have to check whether this omega equal to under root AB radian per second give the maximum or minimum value. So for this we have to again differentiate the terms obtained after dz by j omega, and we have to put omega equal to under root AB in that, and then we have to see whether that will give the maximum value of z or minimum value of z. So let me differentiate again it. So we have to wipe out here. So if we will differentiate again, then d2z by d omega square, this will be equal to 1 plus omega square by AB whole to the power 4, and again 1 minus 1 plus omega square by AB whole square multiplied by 1 minus A 1 by A minus 1 by B, and here we have to differentiate this one. So after differentiating this, how much we will get? We will get minus 2 omega divided by AB, and again it will be minus this term 1 by A minus 1 by B, and 1 minus omega square by AB. Okay, and we have to make the differentiation of this. So differentiation of this will be let me write here. So differentiation of this will be 2 into 1 minus omega square AB into minus 2 omega. So 2 into omega square, sorry, plus, it will be plus 2 into omega square by AB into 2 omega by AB. Now if we take omega h common, 1 plus omega square by AB, and if we put omega equal to under root AB here, then how much we will get? So d2z by d omega square. So it will be, if we put omega square equal to AB, so if we put omega square equal to AB, then it will be 1 plus AB by AB whole square into 1 by A minus 1 by B, and it will be minus 2 into under root AB by AB, and here minus 1 by A minus 1 by B, here 1 minus omega square will be AB by AB, okay, into 2 into 1 plus AB by AB into 2 into under root AB by AB divided by 1 plus AB by AB to the power 4. Here we can see that these two AB will cancel out each other and it will become 1. So the second term will be 0. So we are only left with the first term, which is a negative one. Which is a negative one. Why I am saying which is a negative one? Because as I have told, this is a compensator, this is a lead compensator. So if this is a lead compensator, then A is less than B. So if A is less than B, then 1 minus A will be greater than 1 minus B. So we can say that since A is less than B, hence we can say d2z by d omega square at omega equal to under root ab, this is a negative quantity. So now we have proved that the double differentiation at omega equal to under root ab comes negative. Now since it is negative, so omega equal to under root ab will give the maximum value of phase angle, or you can say phase lead angle. So for omega equal to under root ab, we will get the maximum value of phase lead angle. So now it will depend upon what is the value of A and what is the value of B. From the previous question, A was 1 and B was 2. In that, so let us wipe out this. Now we can say that hence omega equal to under root AB will give maximum phase lead for lead compensator. Okay, now in the previous question, from previous question, we have A equal to 1 and B equal to 2. Okay, so omega will be equal to under root AB means 1 into 2 means under root 2 radian per second. Okay. So which option is correct one? So option number A is the correct one. Next question is the transfer function of two compensators are given. So C1 is one compensator and C2 is another compensator. Which of the following statements is correct? So the question is asking about what type of compensator is C1 and what type of compensator is C2. And this question has been asked in gate 2500. So as we have said in earlier questions also, for a compensator to be lead compensator, the zero should be nearer to origin than the pole. So in C1, zero is at minus 1 and pole is at minus 10. So C1 is a lead compensator, and for a compensator to be lag compensator, zero should be farther from origin then pole. So here 0 is at minus 10 and pole is at minus 1. So C2 is a lag compensator. So C1 is a lead compensator and C2 is a lag compensator. So let us see which one is correct. So C1 is a lead compensator and C2 is a lag compensator. So option number A is the correct one. The next question is the system 900 divided by S into S plus 1 into S plus 9 is to be such that its gain crossover frequency becomes same as its uncompensated phase crossover frequency and provides a 45 degree phase margin. To achieve this, one may use, there are four alternatives given, and this question has been asked in gate 2007. So let us find which alternative is correct one. The system transfer function is given as TS equal to TS equal to 900 divided by S into S plus 1, S plus 9. So if we replace S by J omega, replacing S by J omega, we get T J omega equal to 900 by J omega plus 1, J omega plus 9. Now, magnitude of T J omega is, magnitude T J omega, this is equal, this is nothing but 900 by omega into under root 1 plus omega square, under root omega square plus 9 square, and angle of TJ omega, that will be equal to 0, since in numerator there is no 0, so 0 minus angle due to pole at origin will be, that will be 90 degree. So it is 0 minus 90 degree minus tan inverse omega by 1, so tan inverse omega minus tan inverse omega by 9. So this is the angle of the system TJ omega. So now the question is saying that its gain crossover frequency becomes same as its uncompensated phase crossover frequency. Okay, so it's the question is saying that the gain, its gain crossover frequency becomes same as its uncompensated phase crossover frequency. That means we have to calculate the uncompensated phase crossover frequency. So we have to calculate the phase crossover frequency for this system. So the phase crossover frequency is given by the phase crossover frequency for TS or for TJ omega is omega phi, omega T omega T angle, that will T J omega P will be equal to at phase crossover frequency, the angle will be equal to minus 180 degree. So this will be equal to minus 180 degree, and now what is T J omega P? T J omega P is minus 90 degree. So from here we can write minus 90 degree minus tan inverse omega P minus tan inverse omega P by 9, and that will be equal to minus 180 degree. Now, if we take the negative sign common from here and and cancel out negative sign in both sides, left side and right side, then it will become tan inverse omega p plus tan inverse omega p by 9, this will be equal to 90 degree. Because this will be equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree, so it will be 90 degree. Now, if we solve this, then it will become tan inverse omega p plus omega p by 9 divided by 1 minus omega p into omega p by 9, that will be equal to 90 degree. This implies omega p plus omega p by 9 divided by 1 minus omega p square by 9, that will be equal to tan 90 degree. And what is the value of tan 90 degree? The value of tan 90 degree is infinite, and this can only be possible if the terms in denominator is equal to 0. So from here, let me write here. So from here we can write 1 minus omega p square by 9, 1 minus omega p square by 9, that is equal to 0. This means omega p equal to 3 radian per second. Now we have got the uncompensated phase loss over frequency of the system. So now we have got the frequency. So the question is asking that the system is to be such that its gain crossover frequency becomes same as uncompensated phase crossover frequency. So this is the phase crossover frequency for uncompensated system, and this is the phase crossover frequency for uncompensated system. So this is for uncompensated, let me write here in bracket, for an uncompensated system. So or we can write, we can wipe out from here itself, and then we will write. Now the phase crossover frequency over frequency for uncompensated system is equal to 3 radian per second, and this is equal to the gain crossover frequency of compensated system. So this is that's why I am writing here, this is equal to the gain crossover frequency of the gain crossover frequency of the compensated system. The compensated system. Again, one more thing is given. For compensated system, the phase margin is 45 degree phase margin. So we have to calculate the phase margin at gain crossover frequency, and as we know the gain crossover frequency is 3 radian per second. So what is the gain of uncompensated system? The gain of uncompensated system was T j omega, that was equal to 900 divided by omega under root 1 plus omega square under root 9 square plus omega square. This was the gain of uncompensated system. So at gain crossover frequency, the gain will be at omega, or you can say at omega equal to 3, the gain of the system will be, let me write this. So this implies TJ3, because we have put omega equal to 3, this will be equal to 900 divided by 3 into under root, what is omega square? Omega square will be 9, 3 square, under root 81 plus, this is 3 square means 9, so 90 into 10. So what will be it? It will be 900 divided by 3 into under root 10 into 90, so under root 900. So if we calculate the root of under root of 900, then how much it will come? It will come 30. So 900 divided by 3 into 30, this will give 90, so it will come 10. So Now we can say that the compensator is providing a gain of 1 by 10, a gain of 1 by 10 at omega equal to 3 radians per second. That's why if the compensator is providing a gain of 1 by 10, that's why the gain of compensated system becomes equal to 1 at 3 radians per second. So we should write here, since the gain of compensated system at omega equal to the gain of compensated system at omega equal to 3 radian per second is equal to 1, and hence gain provided by compensator, only compensator, at omega equal to 3 radian per second is equal to, and hence gain provided by the compensator is calculated as at omega equal to 3 radian per second is as follows. Mod GC, GC is the compensator transfer function, J3, multiplied by mod TJ3. This is equal to 1. Why I am saying this is equal to 1? Because the gain crossover frequency of compensated system is 3 radians per second. And at gain crossover frequency, the gain of the system becomes equal to 1. So the gain of the compensated system will become equal to 1 at 3 radians per second. And this TJ3, I have found that this TJ3 is equal to 10. So now we can write here mod GJ3, this will be equal to mod GJ3, this will be equal to 1 by TJ3. That is equal to 1 by 10. From here, because TJ3 is 10. Now, in dB, we can calculate in dB decibel the value of 20J3. So, 20 log mod GJ3, this will be equal to 20 log 1 by 10. So its value will be minus 20 dB. So this compensator, the compensator GC, J omega, is providing a attenuation of 20 dB per decade at 3 radians per second. So now we have got two things. We have got the frequency. We have got the frequency 3 radians per second, and another we have got the attenuation of 20 dB per decade, minus 20 dB. So let us see a lag compensator that provides an attenuation of 20 dB and a phase lag of 45 at frequency of this 3 root 3 radians. This is not correct because we have got 3 radians per second. Again, a lead compensator that provides an amplification of 20, and it is not providing an amplification, it is providing an attenuation. So this B option is also not correct. A lag lead compensator that provides an amplification of 20 dB and phase lag of 45 dB at the frequency of 3 radians per second, this is also not correct because it is providing attenuation and frequency is root 3 radian, root, not root 3 radian per second. A live lead compensated diet provides an attenuation of 20 dB and phase lead of 45 dB at the frequency of 3 radian per second. This is correct because here it is saying that provide 45 degree phase margin. Since it is providing 45 degree, since phase margin is 45 degree, so at 3 radian per second, before that at 3 radian per second, the angle of original system was minus 180 degree. So if the compensator could provide a phase lead of 45 degree, then the phase margin would be 45 degree. So option number D is correct one. The next question is ds equal to 0.5 s plus 1 divided by 0.05 s plus 1. Maximum phase lead of the compensator is, there are four alternatives given and this question has been asked in gate 2000. So this is the transfer function of compensator. So let us write ds, it is given that ds equal to 0.5 s plus 1 divided by 0.05 s plus 1. Now if we convert it in s plus a into s plus b form, so it will be 0.5, we will take 0.5 as common, so 0.5 s plus, this will be 2, here we will take 0.05 common, so here s plus 1 by 0.05, so now it will come 0.5 by 0.05 means 10, this will be 10, 0.5 by 0.05 will be 10, 10 into s plus 2 divided by s plus 20. So this is the transfer function of compensator. Now A is, as we have seen in previous questions also, the maximum phase lead, this is a lead type of compensator because 0 is nearer to origin than the pole. So 0 is at minus 2 and pole is at minus 20. So this is a phase lead type of compensator. So and the maximum, and we have seen in previous questions, the maximum phase lead occurs at omega equal to under root AB. So the maximum phase lead will be, now the maximum phase lead will be at omega equal to under root 2 into 20 radian per second. So under root 40 radian per second. So if it is under root 40 radian per second, so it is about 6 point something. It is around about 6.7 radian per second. So the maximum phase lead occurs at omega m. Let me write it as omega m. Omega m equal to 6.6 radian per second. And what is the maximum phase lead? So the maximum phase lead is equal to the maximum phase lead that is equal to tan inverse omega m by 2 minus tan inverse omega m by 20. So what is tan inverse omega m by 2? So omega m is 6.6 by 2 minus tan inverse 6.6 by 20. So it is tan inverse 3.3 minus tan inverse 0.33. So how much it will come? So if we calculate this, then it is coming, if since calculator is allowed, you can directly calculate from calculator in the exam, and it will come round about 55 degree. So maximum phase lead is 55 degree at 6.6 radian per second. So 55 degree is here, but the frequency is not correct. So none of the above answer is correct. So option number D is correct. Now at the last of the lecture, I would like to share one of the most important thing to you people, that if you like my video, then you must subscribe my video, so that there is no need to search out new video. Automatic update will come if I upload the new videos. What you have to do, it is very simple. There is a circular logo coming in right of me. You have to just click on that to subscribe.